Evening, Arthur.
Oh, careful, Javier.
Look out!
Dutch one. Cornwall and Annisburg. This'll be bad, John.
How did you get on, Mr. Morgan?
Just dandy. Hmm. Just get up.
What?
Get up!
What is wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Nothing at all.
What are you doing?
Something I should have done a long time ago. Get your bag. Is this it?
I don't understand.
I ain't gonna kill you. Though I probably should. You disgust me. And you shame us. If we could be shamed any more than we already are, that should do. Go!
I don't understand you. What are you doing?
Go and get a job!
You know, they say the sick delude themselves. I was your friend.
You and me, we ain't decent. But those folk, they was. Now here. Take that. Take that and get lost.
I'm
leaving.
Evening, Mr. Morgan.
Bill.
Well, I think I can feel a piss coming on.
Eden.
Hello.
Don't you give me that look.
So just like that, Strauss is gone? Yeah.
For his own good. This is done, Abigail. Not exactly a welcome home party.
Well, you warned me.
I'll fill you in some more later. Okay, guess I'll see you later then.
Be strong.
I'm gonna turn in.
Come all of you, my brother scouts, and join me in the sun.
so long. Of all the old frontiersmen that used to scour the plain, there are but very few of them that with us still remain. Day after day they're dropping off, they're going one by one. Our clan is fast decreasing, our race is almost run. There are many of our numbers that never wore the blue, but faithfully they did their part as brave men tried and true. They never joined the army, but had other work to do, in piloting the coming folks to help them safely through. But brothers, we are failing, our race is almost run. The days of elk and buffalo and beaver traps are done. Oh, the days of elk and buffalo, it fills my heart with pain. To know those days are past and gone, to never come again. We fought against the Redskins over valley, hill, and plain. We fought them in the mountaintop and fought him down again. But those fighting days are over, the Indian yell resounds. No more along the border, peace sends far sweeter sounds. But we found great joy, our comrades, to hear and make it die. We won bright homes for gentle ones, and now our west, goodbye.
Reminds me of the old days.
Are you all right? Strauss is gone.
It was time. Well, try to keep your head straight.
We'll just soldier on, I guess.
Uncle?
You got a fever or something? It's too cold to dress like that.
How are you coping?
I ain't doing so good.
I apologize in advance for this stew. It needs better meat. Look at the quality on this. Should fetch a good price. Thank you, Arthur. I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things around here if you want to take a look. I'll need you to go find me the right materials before I can make that.
I'll keep my eye out for some good materials. You awake yet?
What, Arthur?
Look, I'm sorry. Guess I'm just tired.
I'm too tired for this.
Hey, get up. Reverend?
You okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself somehow. I've always felt... I've left the morphine, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York?
We are going to go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west. We're going to get a boat, we're going to get on a river, and we're going to go north.
New York.
Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dancing girls, freedom. But first, we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion?
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, I'm fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. I brought a friend, Arthur.
Hello.
Hello.
Dutch, this is Eagle Flash. His father is a great chief. Charles and I, we...
pretended to be mercenaries. Did me a great favor.
Dutch Vanderlyn. How do you do?
Not well, sir.
Well, I am sorry to hear that.
How's your father?
Father has confused wisdom with weakness. His people, my people, we've suffered too much, been lied to too much. Now they've taken our horses.
Who?
The infantry division posted at Fort Wallace.
Why?
Colonel Favors is a liar and a murderer. His people won't stop until we're all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting, we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
You men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah. Arthur, we must go with them. To try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along. We can get them more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping them up into a frenzy. We got enough folks coming after us without adding army to the list.
You going to let these bastards walk all over you? No. You're not. This is all that's wrong with this. World.
Okay, then, girl.
Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near Van Horn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be, will be. Anyway, son. Tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. He and his regiment take pleasure in persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. The old are weak and sick, but they deliberately withhold medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that.
Getting involved in this, Dutch.
You know me. We shoot fellers as need shooting. We save fellers as need saving. Feed them as need feeding.
Not this again. It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves, and even you know that.
I told you. Noise. We need noise, Arthur. Noise and faith.
I still don't know what that means.
Stop questioning and think. Just think for a second. The Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly told them? We need to move towards a conclusion now.
Sure, but what's this got to do with any of that?
Some good, honest conflict between the army and the Indians might be just the distraction we need. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with him? With Cornwall gone, the government is far more likely to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. And then we can slip away. Like I said, we just need that noise and one more score. know I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell? And we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Micah found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta. These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Come on, let's go.
Silently, board her. And when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor, float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
Good luck. Try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
I'm gonna go smoke, all right? Be back in a bit.
Something about that anchor, Arthur. Aren't you dealing with the anchor?
I prefer the other one.
Come on, Arthur! You think I have the first idea how this anchor works?
Just blow it up then. Hurry. Come on, Arthur.
Quite the best pilot I've ever come across.
The horses are confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Over here, come on.
Come here. Come on. Come here.
Oh, seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. Father doesn't want to fight again.
Well, he is a wise man, but you know, I think that I agree with you. There's only so much treachery and betrayal that a man can take before he must admit to himself that he is no longer a man.
Come on.
Never thought about it in those terms.
An old friend of Evelyn Miller like you, I doubt that.
Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur... Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we gonna wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea. And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Cone. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combs dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
Sure. Oh. I'll speak with him. You head on back to camp. Check on the others. Touch his behavior. It's...
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
Thank you.
to help.
Ah, there he is. Old Black Lung Morgan.
Shut up.
Was you followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
You know who you're talking to.
I ain't sure. I ain't sure about much no more. All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
Is that so? Because it seems to me that since you've been riding with us, there ain't been nothing but trouble. Stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear. Seems wherever you is, there's Pinkertons and vice versa. So you better watch your goddamn mouth, boy! Or...
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief, way you're heading.
Micah, shut it!
He started it! Dutch says we is to go on with plans to create a diversion. We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge. Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time. Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it. Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us. Only you ain't well.
I'm fine!
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding, which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Rob a stage. All we seem to ever do is rob a stage, you and me.
Not me, you two. I got my own planning to do. You boys got this.
Shit. Guess we have. Come on, Arthur.
And cowpoke, take it easy. You could do with a vacation, hmm?
All right, let's go.
Come on, girl.
Hey, what are you doing? We should jump it as soon as it comes through Van Horn.
So you're taking orders from him now?
I'm taking orders from Dutch, same as always.
The pair of them are becoming unhinged. You hear about Dutch killing Cornwall?
Hey, hold up a second. Pinkerton patrol over there. Okay, I think we're clear. Let's head off.
So, you were saying?
Well, that needed to be done.
Right now? With the Pinkertons breathing down our necks?
See, I'm starting to think that you've gone soft, Morgan. Okay. Let's hold up here. So, wagon will be coming from that way, down from Annisburg. It'll take the two of us to stop it completely, or it'll never get done. So, I was thinking, you go play dead, and I'll take care of him.
No, I'm the better shot, and you're the better actor. No, you play dead, and I'll cover you.
I got that. I got that. Oh, that's them coming now, I think. It'll be quite the show.
Thank you.
Come on, let's get you out of...
Let's see if we can get this back to camp without blowing ourselves up. Nice. Back there.
Nice drunk playing.
Comes naturally. Whoa. I could use a drink after that.
Ah, no. This never goes easy no more, does it?
Oh, shit! Deal with them, Arthur!
Okay, I'm trying.
Quit! You know, one good shot, the blood will go to kingdom come. I thought there was no law in the...
Does that really matter right now? so we can rob some dynamite blow.
Look, there's Micah up ahead.
Great. Yep. Whoa!
So, you got it?
We got it. Yes, we got it.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Nothing at all, boss.
John, go drive this over to Bacchus Bridge. Get it hidden ear there.
He really does think he's in charge.
You go on ahead. I need to speak with Arthur. Good work, son.
What's going on?
Listen, I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. But right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur. But I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live. Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said, Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur. Trust me.
Yeah.
Easy, easy.
My, my. I was wondering when I was gonna see you again.
You look different.
Well, the rigors of simplicity take their toll on a woman.
Oh, no, I didn't mean
it. No, I know. Things are going well. I couldn't have done it without you.
Oh, you did it all yourself.
So how are you holding up?
I'm still standing. Which is an improvement on the last time you saw me.
I wish that there was something else that I could do.
Ma'am, you have done more than enough.
Please, call me Charlotte.
Arthur. Arthur Morgan.
Well, you take care of yourself, Arthur. Please, go on in and help yourself to anything you need. What's mine is yours.
Oh, well, that's very kind. Charlotte, it was a pleasure meeting you.
You too, Arthur. Please be well.
Whoa, whoa!
Someone's coming. Someone's coming. Let's go.
Maury, of course.
If you want Dickens, you have.
You'll freeze. What has gotten into
you? Calm down. Oh. Could really use some good meat for this stew. Don't you overcook this now, Pearson. You'll be able to make something nice with that.
Many thanks, Mr. Morgan. This camp could do with a few improvements. Why don't you take a look at my ideas? Thanks, Mr. Pearson.
起来了，小孩儿，起来，起来。
妈，
快。
阿姨做的啥好吃的？
做烙饼。
这个我也会，我来试一下。好嘞。上面再撒上他们晒干的野果子。做温客出身，他们以面食为主，烙饼子一定要小火慢烤，来回翻滚。阿姨啊，你们平时是怎么生火的呀？
来，小伙子，
啊，
那我们的鹿奶茶。
嗯，好嘞，谢谢。嗯，焦香的饼子混合着清香的鹿奶，吃在嘴里简直太得劲了。
a good girl. Yep. You done good, girl.
I was just telling my friend here about how I nearly died out there one night.
Ooh, sounds like quite a tale.
Here's an idea. Gunsmith's a friend. Pick out what you want, and I'll pick up the tab. Huh? It's Jenkins.
Ooh, yes, indeed.
Anything for you, buddy. Anything.
You are nothing if not generous.
That's kind of you. Thanks.
You're very welcome, friend. All the best. Well, he did save my life after all. I probably would have gotten it over.
Hey, friend, what do you need?
Man in town named Jenkins owes me. Said I could put something on his tab.
Jenkins, huh? All right, take a look around. So noted. You have a good day now.
I said, hell, even a blind hog finds an acorn every once in a while.
Hey, you want company, boys?
Sure, because I want to be pissing needles tomorrow.
This is town.
Go away. Just go away.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, but I... Well...
Well, you're sorry. Yeah, I heard you.
But, I mean, well, this country is man unleashed. That's the thing, and it ain't my fault any more than it is anyone else.
Man unleashed? Then unleash goodness. Not just hell's feeble brothers, sir.
But how? I mean, all I know how to do is fight, I guess. I was set free to fight. Where's your son, Mrs. Down?
Where you think? Down the mine, until he gets sick. Which won't be long, given how hard they work him. See, Fulman don't like him, so he gets the worst of it.
Maybe I could go...
Well, maybe you could just leave us all alone. Maybe. Maybe you could just go fight some other battle.
Good evening.
Excuse me, partner.
Hey, boy!
Hey, boy, your mom's a whore, little boy.
Why don't you shut up?
Oh, all right.
Who's this, your daddy?
My daddy died. And this man, he killed him. What are you doing here?
Leave the boy alone.
Why'd you kill his daddy? You after his mama?
Stop bullying the boy.
Get out of my business, mister.
Leave the boy alone.
Or what?
Or I'll kill you too.
You couldn't kill no one. Look at you, all ragged and sick and weak. Clear off, you goddamn hermit. Clear off! You and the horse son here.
Can't even fight your own battles, Downs?
Get off me!
You and that diseased whore!
Take your hands off me!
Now who's next? Let the boy go. Let him go! Come with me. Shame on you. He's just a goddamn boy! Let's get you out of here.
But they're gonna kill me. Now I got no job and they're gonna kill me.
I've got some money. You and your mama can go someplace nice.
Well, why are you doing this?
I don't know. Listen, take this. All of it. Try and talk to your mama and get out of here. Now run.
I'll try.
Good boy. I don't want to see you here again.
Hello, gentlemen.
I reckon you've already made enough trouble around here, don't you?
Evening, sir.
Everything okay? You know when you have one of those days?
Is that so?
Have a nice evening.
Evening, mister.
Good evening to you.
Pleasant evening to you.
Partner?
Hello, Hello, sir.
Train's due to arrive shortly. Prepare to board. Traveling mercies to you.
Hello.
How do you do?
Hey there.
Hello.
Hey there, mister.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Hi, what can I do for you?
What's playing?
Oh, yes. The Legend of Josiah Blackwater. Locals seem to like it.
Can I buy a ticket, please?
Make your way through the doors on either side of me.
Example of modern entertainment at its finest. Now, most of you youngins, I'm sure, know about our great national hero and pioneer, Josiah Blackwater. Him that gave the town of Blackwater its nomenclature. You see, only about 100 years ago, weren't nothing here but big old forests, ferocious beasts, surly savages, arid deserts, and unconquered mountains. The West, well, the whole West was untamed. Your mama probably told you bedtime stories about Josiah's many adventures. But I'm gonna tell you a story you ain't likely to have heard about his possum hat. Now, Josiah Blackwater was born in the year of our Lord, 1782, in a log cabin just west of Amesburg. He was a special boy. His pop gave him his first rifle when he was 3 years old. Boy, he took to it right away. He exclaimed, "There's a whole mess of critters out there in them woods that aim to eat us. So I'm going to consume them first." Yes, sir. He really took to killing all manner of things. He was such a keen shot. One morning, he was sorting up some winter turnips for the root cellar when a big old bear and her cubs came in the kitchen hunting for food. It had a mind to eat up all the jams and preserves. Josiah grabbed that bear and wrestled her to the ground and squeezed and squeezed and squeezed. He whooped the tar clean out of that big old critter. Then he tied her up, grabbed them cubs, and ground them into sausages while the mama bear watched. That's fine eating. His ma and pa knew right then he was cut out to be the finest wild frontiersman that ever drew breath. But first, they wanted him to get some book learning. After only 3 days of attending school, Josiah beat the living daylights out of a class bully and announced to his daddy that he was tired of ciphering and mathematics on account it's only good for adding up the number of critters or Indians you can kill. So he ran away from home and headed west. Now, these lands were occupied by savages then, and when Josiah Blackwater came scouting through, he recognized it to be a land of splendor, wasted on those that couldn't appreciate it on account of worshiping false idols. He got rid of all them pesky buffalo, and thereby ensured those infernal Indians didn't have nothing to eat. Of course, that got them mightily riled up, so he had to slaughter all of them, too. Just like his daddy had once done to the Redcoats in 1775. Right about that time, he met an Indian girl he took pity on account of having annihilated her family. She was 12 years old, and so he took her as his wife. She gave him two sons before she died of typhus. Now, y'all know that Josiah Blackwater wore a possum for a hat, but most don't know how that came to be. Well, one day, old Josiah was riding a couple of alligators down the Lanahatchee River, riding, standing up, and shooting eagles right out of the sky, when he sees a big old mountain lion about to eat a possum. Josiah grabbed that mountain lion by the tail and wrestled it till it was plumb dead. Well, that possum really took to Josiah, followed him around like a dog loyal to its master. Yes, they had a lot of adventures together. Now Josiah never cried a day in his life, but he pert near dead on the day that possum passed, for they were mighty fine friends. So he skinned it and made it into a hat. Back in them days, a possum skin was as good as money, but he never parted with that hat, not even for $10. Once he founded the town of Blackwater, he sent word for settlers to come. It was the last stop in the west before San Francisco. He met a girl by the name of Rufina Helsby at a barn dance one night, took her as his wife, and settled down. Built himself a cattle empire and had 14 youngins. But Josiah Blackwater wasn't the home-loving kind, and he grew mighty restless. One day on the courthouse steps, he announced, "You may all go to hell, and I will go to Saint Denis." And so he did. Enjoyed French pursuits of strumpets and wanton gluttony, which is where he came upon the idea of running for Congress. He wore that possum hat every day as a congressman as a reminder of where he come from, saying, "I may live in barbaric splendor, but I always remember, keep your friends close and your gun closer, because you don't know when you might have to shoot them."
Thank you.
see you. Come back for another one.
How is everything with you? I sure am sorry.
Spend all day on that one, huh?
Hey, you deaf, mister?
Got big mouths, don't you? Bet you wouldn't miss some teeth. Stop, or I start shooting.
Let's get those hands up nice and high.
Works every time.
You're as good as Barry.
I'll get you for this. Come on, somebody hit this fool already.
Damn it.
Someone kill him already.
Thank you.
guard.
Let's go, girl.
What's going on?
Hey, move it.
Buenos dias.
Morning to you.
Good morning, sir.
Don't you worry about me.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
So?
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, don't we just look the part?
We'll cut through the alley to get to the gallows. We keep our weapons holstered, our disguises on, and our wits about us.
Mrs. Adler, might I say, being a fancy woman of Saint Denis suits you.
I'd dress up like the Queen of Sheba if it meant seeing that son of a bitch swing.
Colm hung me up, nearly butchered me. That don't mean I'm comfortable in this woolen coat.
You made it out of that predicament, as I remember, Mr. Morgan. My husband weren't so lucky.
You lost your husband. I lost my darling Annabelle. That poor boy Kieran. We've all lost something because of Colm. And that is why we will shepherd him to eternity.
Amen to the...
those fingers off those triggers, because we'll need cool heads and calm dispositions to see this done.
Practice what you preach, brother.
Whatever do you mean?
Are you gonna keep your cool? Really? When you seem to lose it all so often now.
This doubting and questioning of yours, I miss the old Arthur.
Don't we all?
You two quit it. We all got a job to do, and we're all in rough agreement about how we're doing it. As far as I can tell.
Exactly.
We'll get it done, all right.
All right, then. Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here. Don't the public love an execution? Hey, we're gonna...
All right, good. Now,
you see that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Combs boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them and find out.
Yeah. Oh, here comes somebody. Stay here. Don't do nothing. Go brush that horse, officer.
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
I guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey, hey, you know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
Well, I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his. He's turned down there. Let's go. Quiet.
What's it look like? A
bunch of cops.
How many?
Enough. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah, I guess we faced worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So, they got a guy up on the roof overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there, onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe, and get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously, I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing. To their own, my friend.
Je vous salue.
Ma'am, I need to get out onto the roof. You know how I can do that?
I guess you could go out on the balcony if you took the stairs up a level.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Howdy, officer.
Bonjour.
Monsieur.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Can remember, it is justice that separates us from barbary. Yet justice itself can at times be barbaric. For sometimes a man is so savage, the only way to deal with him justly is by savagery. Colm O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states, seemingly with impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges are...
This is not a court where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out, and your sentence, Colm O'Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy, but it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Colm O'Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life!
Morgan, you hear us? Take a shot on these O'Driscolls!
Come on, calm your very best.
How you get on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but the whole thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Como Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, you never showed up. And now, after looking at the newspapers, I understand why. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter, but I, nonetheless, must send it. Arthur. Oh, Arthur. I was just starting to dream the silliest and softest of dreams. I miss you, and I will always miss you. But I cannot live like that. And it seems you cannot live any other way. When I'm with you, the world makes sense, but when we are apart, I see clearly that your world is not a world from which one can escape. I'm so sorry for everything long ago, and for starting up that business again. There's a good man within you, Arthur, but he is wrestling with a giant. And the giant wins time and again. You've broken my heart again. And I fear I have broken yours. And for that, I will never forgive myself. But you must let me go now. I enclose a ring you gave me many years ago. When we were both young. Not because I don't like it, but because I care for it. Far too much, and it reminds me too much of you. I hope one day you will find some people in love who can use this, for it kept me thinking of you all these years, and I hope by returning it to you, I can finally be free. Goodbye, Mary.
So, you got tired of making money, did you, Black Lung?
Go to hell.
Well, I guess it's true what they say. You can't take it with you. But Herr Strauss, I thought you liked helping the weak and unfortunate.
You're unfortunate. I don't like helping you.
Very amusing. Just try to stop making more trouble for us. Some of us are trying to save folk, not make unnecessary dramas.